I'm not sure if I'm qualified enough for being called here, because I don't think I'm any intellect or any official or anything of that sort to be invited, but I feel really blessed for calling me here. Well, first let me introduce myself first. I am Karthikeya. I am from Hyderabad. I'm from a total non-filmy backdrop, and right from my childhood, the only dream I had was being an actor. But then, during my school days, the only thing I was allowed to is studying, because my parents own a school in Vanasalipuram. So because of the educational background they are from, I was really not allowed to do anything apart from studies. I used to dance here and there for my cultural programs and stuff, but then I wasn't really allowed. So I used to get home tuitions for 5-6 hours daily, and then school, and then getting up and morning again home tuition. So this was my routine, and every weekend, every Saturday, I was allowed to watch one movie. So the whole week, that one movie was my entertainment. And the gap between each tuition teacher, I used to go in front of the mirror and enact the dialogues or any dance movement from the movie. And if there is any cultural program, since I was allowed to dance, I used to follow the dance movements from the theater itself, because that time we did not have the YouTube. So especially Chiranjeev Garu's dance, because he is the obvious inspiration for anyone who wants to get into acting in Telugu. His dance movements were my inspiration. I used to watch his movies three to four times every week, and the same steps in the theater itself, I used to memorize them and perform on stage later. And this was the only source of entertainment I had. And I finished my 10th, and after 10th, you know what we get into. I can't name. So after that, we are the little entertainment we have till 10th also will be lost. So those 2 years will be put under section 144 or something like that. People from Tihar jail will have better facilities than us. And they will be having more freedom than us, because they will not be having study hours like that. The people in jail at least don't have study hours, I guess. At least they will be made to work, I guess. That is much better. So those 2 years, we can't expect anything of that sort. Sometimes I used to jump off the college hostel and go watch some movies. So because of those 2 years, and then those 2 years I wasn't allowed to do anything else, because my mom challenged everyone that I'll get into IIT. But then first time I couldn't get it. Then I had to do long term, and that 1 year I had to study again and slog. Then I got into NIT Warangal after great difficulties and great struggles. And during all this struggle to get into NIT, there used to be those students always in the class who are called toppers. So these people, they screw up everyone's life in the class. Because the main reason for them for getting those top marks also would be because they can dominate over us. Do you agree with me? I'm sorry, toppers. Because these people, what they do is, because we own a school, my dad used to have many students, and among them there are many toppers. These people, they come to my home when I end up getting some 10,000 rank in MCET. This guy comes and says, and he takes blessings from my father and touches the feet of my father, saying he got 2,000 rank. And though he knows what rank I got, still he comes and asks in front of my dad. And there will be few girls who now text me. Now they text me though I am not replying them now. One day will come. So though they text me now, those days they disclaimer, I was really fat then, because the only thing I was allowed to study and nothing else. So I used to, the only entertainment I had is either movies or eating Hyderabadi biryani. So I was really fat back then. So these girls, they used to study really well, and they come home and they give that feedback to my mom that they studied that, they studied this, and I was the culprit in front of my mom. Amma illu chusi nerchukora vallu neekanna better ga unnara. So I used to feel my, though I was like decently good at studies, these topper used to make me feel myself as a failure every time. So those people used to appear like some sort of villainistic superheroes, not Hulk, the other person, Thanos. Yeah. Yeah, all these toppers used to be appear like Thanos for me. And then somehow I'll tell you why I'm using all these words later. So somehow I got into NIT with great difficulties, because the amount of pressure my mom put and the amount of tuitions I have undergone, if anyone else of little more brain did that, he used to crack some IAS or IPS. Edo naaku anta teliyaledu kabatti just settled with NIT. So after getting into college, that's when my life took another turn. So right from my childhood, though I had this dream of being an actor, I never had that courage to even tell that to anyone because of my circumstances. And I never had guts to tell that even to my best friend because of the way I was looking. I was really fat, I had no confidence, I was an introvert. And in Fiji, there were many good-looking girls, and I used to just look at them with getting scared to even go and talk to them, where these other city guys used to move with them, and I was like looking at them, when will I get a chance to move with them like that. So this was my state. So getting after Fiji and after long term, getting into college, I was that introvert guy who failed to get into IIT and got into NIT, and really fat, and had this small aspiration in the heart, who did not tell to anyone, that he wants to be an actor. And I then realized that after going to NIT, I don't have to really study there. Because in engineering, what I realized is the only time we study is the day before exam. And my mom won't be there along with me, so I was really, really happy. So I took really good advantage of that, and I first spoke to myself in the mirror after I got into college that these 4 years I shall use, and I shall realize, I shall make myself understand whether I want to be an actor or not. 4 years gattigat nannu nenu change chesukodaniki try chestan. In case by the end of 4th year, if I will be able to prove myself at least that I am capable of being an actor, then after 4 years I am going to pursue acting. If not, then I don't know what my life is going to be. So by the end of 1st year, I started going to gym, getting into good shape, then improved my dancing skills. And in college, 90% of the time I was only in SAC, means the student activity center, where I used to be in my mirror room practicing dance, or I used to be on auditorium dancing for the song. And by the in 3rd year, I started doing short films, which I feel embarrassed looking at them right now. So in 3rd year, I started doing short films, and by the end of final year, My aim in first year was at least proving to myself that by the end of final year, I could manage my whole college, that they started believing me that I can be an actor immediately after I go out of the college. I could convince my whole college. In my own college, I got a name for myself. Thank you. In my own college, I got a name for myself that he's going to be an actor later, and he need not study because he wants to get into acting. And my even teacher used to give pass marks at least. Okay, vidalaga actor avutadantan. So that was the state I achieved. And yeah, by the end of final year, at least 15-20 girls following arrange work. So little girls following, and that was the stage I could achieve by the end of final year. So after final year, now with the confidence that my college gave me, I told my parents with great difficulty that I want to get into acting. Obviously, the answer was no, and the basic problem was they already did so much boosting in front of their friends, because my my mom, the only thing she does is going to temples and talking to her friends there, ki mi abba em chestunadu, though she knows what he is doing. Wantedly, the question comes because I am into NIT and he is into some other little less college, so my mom wants to prove that point. So she asks like that. Every mom does that. How many moms do that? Yeah, I know, every mom does that. So, what happened after college when I said I'm going to give up, they had plans of sending me to USA for doing MS and then coming back and taking up the school or something like that. So, because of that already boosting, all that thing she told about me to them before, now they started asking her questions in reverse. Because all their sons are in USA now studying, and I'm sitting at home thinking that I want to be an actor. So they started asking my mom questions, and my mom couldn't bear that, and she used to come to home and show that anger on me in various ways, which I can't really tell now. So yeah, so that was the situation going on, and obviously, the relatives and other friends, everyone advised obvious answer will be no, because you know how the competition is, you know what it is, you know there are only star sons there, we don't know anyone there, we are not from a non-filmy background, they are going to squeeze you, tokkestaru, nalipestaru, piskestaru, ivanni chepparu. So the only question I told to myself is, see, that's the only thing you wanted right from childhood. In case you are not doing that, and if you do something else, and really achieve what your parents are saying, if you achieve 100 crores also, and I have a big home theater, own home theater at my place, and I'm watching a movie there, then I'll feel bad that I'm not in that movie, though I have 100 crores. So that used to always prick me, and I was like, I don't know if I'll be or not, but I might not be a hero, but I'll end up at least being a junior artist. That gives me more satisfaction than earning 100 crores somewhere else. So I decided to struggle. Then I don't know if I'll be or not. Took up acting course, did my acting course under Subbarao Garu for 8 months, then improved my dancing, did few more short films, started giving auditions, and got some training in martial arts done, been doing small roles in the movies which never got released, and few were completed but they did not release, and etc. One movie got released last year which no one knows, and then finally, yeah, after 4 years, RX100 happened. Now, people are saying this is a success. So now my question is, now I got into NIT, which had a lot of struggle. I got RX100 in my life, which had a lot of struggle, which involved more hard work. RX100 or NIT? RX100 తెచ్చుకొని ఈరోజు మీ ముందు నన్ను నిల్చోవడంలో ఎక్కువ హార్డ్ వర్క్ ఉందా, ఆ రోజు నేను ఎన్ఐటి క్రాక్ చేయడంలో ఎక్కువ హార్డ్ వర్క్ ఉందా? ఓకే, ఇప్పుడు ఇంకొక క్వశ్చన్, జనరల్ క్వశ్చన్. ఇఫ్ యు వాంట్ దేర్ ఈజ్ ఏ ట్రీ క్లైంబింగ్ కాంపిటీషన్, చెట్టెక్కే కాంపిటీషన్, అండ్ దేర్ ఈజ్ ఎ స్విమ్మింగ్ కాంపిటీషన్. There are two competitions, not for us, for different types of animals. So who would win tree climbing competition? A monkey, a tiger, or a fish? Who would win a swimming competition? If you put fish to climb the mountain, ad enta hard work chesina will be able to climb? If you put a monkey to swim, ఎంత హార్డ్ వర్క్ చేసినా విల్ ఇట్ బి ఏబుల్ టు బీట్ ఎ ఫిష్? అండ్ కెన్ టైగర్ డూ ఐదర్ ఆఫ్ దాట్? టైగర్ ఈజ్ సపోజ్ టు హంట్. సో టైగర్ విల్ హ్యావ్ టు డూ మోర్ హార్డ్ వర్క్ ఇన్ వాటర్ అండ్ ఆన్ ట్రీ, అండ్ ఫిష్ విల్ హ్యావ్ టు డూ మోర్ హార్డ్ వర్క్ అవుట్ సైడ్. బట్ లీవింగ్ ఫిష్ ఇన్ వాటర్ అండ్ మేకింగ్ ఇట్ స్విమ్ అండ్ గెటింగ్ గోల్డ్ మెడల్, ఇట్స్ నాట్ హార్డ్ వర్క్ ఫర్ ఇట్. ఇట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఇట్ సపోజ్ టు డూ. So now I repeat the question again. RX100 lo ekku hard work unda, NIT lo ekku hard work? So you okay, so na point entante, మనం బేసిక్గా ఎందుకు పనికి వస్తామో ఆ పని చేయాలి. ఆ పని చేస్తే అందులో హార్డ్ వర్క్ ఉండదు. నే చిన్నప్పటి నుంచి నేను చెప్పిన ఎగ్జాంపుల్ అంతా, ఇట్ వాజ్ రియల్ 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 హార్డ్ వర్క్ ఫర్ మీ, అండ్ ద ఓన్లీ ఎంజాయ్మెంట్ ఐ హ్యాడ్ వాజ్ వాచింగ్ మూవీ అండ్ డ్యాన్సింగ్ ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ ఫర్ కల్చరల్ ప్రోగ్రామ్. అండ్ ఇఫ్ యు అబ్జర్వ్ ఆఫ్టర్ మై కాలేజ్, the 4 years what I did is watching movies and dancing and doing short films. That was my enjoyment or hobby back then, and that's the only thing I'm doing now. So I enjoyment and any 4 years chesan, so that enjoyment became my profession, which gave me RX100. Ante enjoy chestu nan ok roju RX100 vachindi, and people calling it a success. అదంతా కష్టపడి పడి పడి రాకున్నా, మా అమ్మతో కొట్టించుకొని, వాళ్ళతో కొట్టించుకొని, ఆ చాపలతో తిట్టించుకొని అంతా అయ్యి ఆ ఎన్ఐటి తెచ్చుకున్నాను. సో దాట్ ఈజ్ హార్డ్ వర్క్, దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎంజాయ్మెంట్. సో ద టర్మ్ హార్డ్ వర్క్, థ్యాంక్ యూ. సో ద టర్మ్ హార్డ్ వర్క్ ఈజ్ నాట్ పాజిటివ్, ద టర్మ్ హార్డ్ వర్క్ ఈజ్ నెగటివ్. హార్డ్ వర్క్ అన్న పేరులోనే హార్డ్ ఉంది, ఆ హార్డ్ రాడ్ ఆ ఫీలింగ్ ఉంది అందులో. నిజంగా హార్డ్ వర్క్ హార్డ్ వర్క్ అంటారు, కానీ ఐ హేట్ ద టర్మ్ హార్డ్ వర్క్, బికాస్ వెన్ యూ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్ ఫీల్ ఇట్ యాజ్ హార్డ్, వై హౌ కెన్ యూ డూ ఇట్ ఆర్ హౌ కెన్ యూ రియలీ ఎంజాయ్ ఇట్? సో నెవర్ డూ హార్డ్ వర్క్ ఇన్ యువర్ లైఫ్. Enjoy what you're doing, or do only what you enjoy, then you end up getting so-called success. Now generally people say, sare nu cheppindantha baane undi, nenu nachindi cheyalante mari success vastadani guarantee enti? How do you know? Now you got RX100, if you did not get RX100, if you end up trying and do some small movies and end your career like that, what would you do if you don't get success? Now I ask, what ఇఫ్ ఐ డు వాట్ ఈస్ సక్సెస్. ఇప్పుడు సరే ఐ గాట్ ఆర్ఎక్స్ 100, ఇఫ్ యూ కాల్ ఆర్ఎక్స్ 100 యాజ్ సక్సెస్, దెన్ వాట్ ఈజ్ సంథింగ్ లైక్ రంగస్థలం? ఇఫ్ యూ కాల్ రంగస్థలం యాజ్ సక్సెస్, వాట్ ఈస్ బాహుబలి? ఇఫ్ యూ కాల్ బాహుబలి యాజ్ సక్సెస్, వాట్ ఈస్ అవెంజర్స్? దెర్ ఈజ్ సంథింగ్ అబౌవ్ అస్ ఎవ్రీ టైమ్. సో నెవర్ మెజర్ సక్సెస్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ వాట్, ఇఫ్ యూ గాట్ మనీ ఆర్ ఇఫ్ యూ గాట్ ఫేమ్ ఆర్ ఇఫ్ యూ గాట్ సమ్ కార్ ఎట్ యువర్ హోమ్ ఆర్ ఇఫ్ యూ గాట్ సమ్మన్ టు హెల్ప్ యూ. సక్సెస్ ఈజ్ దాట్ స్టేట్ ఆఫ్ మైండ్ వేర్ యూ డూ సంథింగ్ విచ్ యూ లైక్ రైట్ ఫ్రమ్ వెన్ యూ గెట్ అప్ టు వెన్ యూ స్లీప్. పొద్దున్న లేచినప్పటి నుంచి రాత్రి పడుకునే వరకు మీ మనసుకు నచ్చింది మీరు చేస్తే అది సక్సెస్. అది చేస్తూ అది అలా పని. ఇప్పుడు ఆర్ఎక్స్ 100 వచ్చింది, మేము మీకు ఇలా చెప్తున్నాను, లేకపోతే ఇది కూర్చోబెట్టి సిట్టింగ్లో 5 ఫ్రెండ్స్కి చెప్పేటోండి. దట్ ద నెంబర్ చేంజెస్. వెన్ ఐ వాజ్ ఇన్ మై కాలేజ్ 100 పీపుల్ సా మీ డాన్సింగ్. వెన్ ఐ వాజ్ ఇన్ మై ఫస్ట్ ఇయర్, ఇన్ ఫైనల్ ఇయర్ 1000 పీపుల్ సా. వెన్ ఐ వాజ్ డూయింగ్ షార్ట్ ఫిల్మ్ సమ్ 50,000. వెన్ ఐ డిడ్ మై ఫస్ట్ మూవీ మేబీ 1 lakh పీపుల్ న్యూ. నౌ ద ఎంటైర్ 2 స్టేట్స్ నో. సో ద నెంబర్ కీప్స్ చేంజింగ్, బట్ ద వర్క్ రిమైన్స్ సేమ్. So, just keep doing the work, just keep doing what you like. And don't let others decide if it is success or not. నువ్వు స్టార్టింగ్లో కష్టపడుతున్నప్పుడు దే ఆర్ ద సేమ్ పీపుల్ హూ కమెంట్స్ ఏ సక్సెస్ రాదు, ఇదంతా వదిలే, పట్టించుకోకు, చేయ, ఇదంతా చేయ. నవ్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఆర్ఎక్స్ 100 ద సేమ్ పీపుల్ కమెంట్స్ ఐ టోల్డ్ యూ, నేను చెప్పాను నువ్వు చేయాలని, అసలు నువ్వు చేయలేదు ముందు నుంచి, ఇప్పుడు కూడా నేను చెప్పినట్టు నువ్వు నేను చెప్పినట్టు సినిమాలు ఒప్పుకో అంటారు. Though I, now also I don't listen to them, I do what I like, and if I achieve later success, then again they comment, cheppan kada nenu ani. If I don't, then they are the people say, cheptane unna vinadidu ani. So, people are meant to say, they will say. Don't let success depend on what others think about you. నువ్వు పని చేసుకుంటే అదే అదే ఐ హీన్ డూయింగ్ ఆర్ఎక్స్ అని అంటే ఓ వెరీ గుడ్, థ్యాంక్ యూ, సక్సెస్ అయిందంట కదా హ్యాపీ అంటే థ్యాంక్ యూ, అరే కానీ ఇలా చేస్తుంటే ఇంకెక్కువ అయ్యేది, థ్యాంక్ యూ, ఐ డోంట్ లిజన్ టు దెమ్. సో ఫస్ట్ మంత్ర ఫర్ బీయింగ్ హ్యాపీ ఆర్ సక్సెస్ఫుల్ ఈజ్ స్టాప్ లిజనింగ్. స్టాప్ లిజనింగ్ టు సమ్మన్ హూ, స్టాప్ లిజనింగ్ అంటే ఐ డి నాట్ మీన్ స్టాప్ లిజనింగ్ టు యువర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ ఆర్ సమ్ డోంట్ లిజన్ టు ఎనీ వన్. Stop listening to free advisors. And naadu kuda ippudu free advisor ankonde. Stop listening to free advisors who tell you to stop or do something else which you don't want to, force you to do something which you don't want to do. Stop listening to them and stop getting frightened. My chances, if you look at my photograph in my 10th standard, the chances of this guy becoming a hero later is 0/100. Now, here I stand with a success called RX 100. That can happen to anyone. And if it doesn't happen also, at the end you will be happy. So, stop listening. And one more thing. Among all, now I got RX 100. Even if I get bigger hits later, even if I go to the state of some stardom later, the day what I feel my real success is in my BTech, and the first day what I challenged myself, and in the final year what I proved to myself, that I consider as success. And after college, when I decided that I'm going to give up my studies and get into acting and get rejected by the people who just studied 7th class, 8th class, putting names to me, that is success. RX 100 is nothing in front of all that. RX 100 just gave me audience, but all those things made me what I am, made me qualified for RX 100. So, now you are in BTech, right? All of you? Okay, you are in college. So, in college, okay, for me it was BTech, so I can explain with BTech. those 4 years is the only time where you actually be free. In those 4 years, I guess you'll study for about only 50 days, 50. Combination of all the exams. 50 days or 50 nights. To be specific, 50 nights, only night before exam. So the rest some 1,000 days, you are totally free. And no one is going to question you, because when someone asks you what you are doing, you'll say, I'm doing engineering. When you are actually jobless. And after engineering, when you really want to achieve something in your life and try something different and don't take up any job and take, for example, me working from morning to evening, we're doing short films, doing acting course and learning martial arts and trying here and there. When I work so much and come back home, what I get from my parents is, you're jobless. You don't do anything, you just sit at home and eat. And when I was actually doing that in BTech, they were really happy because I'm studying in NIT Warangal. So that this is the time where you can make, where you don't have any responsibilities and parents allow you, society allows you to do anything. So this, if you want to try something different, if you want to explore something which you haven't done till now, this is the time. After college, you are not going to get it. So give your best, whatever you are going to do, give your best only in college, and by the end of the college, you will come to know. You will realize what you want. In case you don't realize, at least you will not repent that I haven't tried. But I hope everyone finds something. See, it need not be something like acting or dance or sports for everyone. It might be related to academics, or it might be some coding, or it might be some sort of creating a new software or new app or anything. For which you are not allotted any grades. Because your BTEC will depend only on CGPA, which is useless after 4 years. And you are forced to get only that CGPA, which is actually useless. Instead of get that for a degree, for study for those 50 days and remaining, use it to develop yourself. Because even if you want to be in the same field, that is so funny. Till 10th, you get all. Till intermediate, it's fine, because that you keep studying, and intermediate you take up some maths, physics, chemistry, MPC, because through that you get into engineering. So what we expect as normal human beings, okay, this might be an extension of maths, physics, chemistry in engineering. But do you actually find maths, physics, chemistry in engineering? No. You find only one or two subjects related to that, but mostly there'll be something else. And every one of us select the branch after engineering, after MCET. We take civil, chemical, CSC, mechanical, IT, etc. But how many of you really know what is inside the branch before selecting? How many of you know what actually CSC is? And there will be a few, I'm not saying the total three, but 99% aitha manlaage untaru. ECE, CSC, triple E, mechanical, civil, chemical, tuck, 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 tick bete sellipothun. We don't know what is actually inside it, or we don't know, for a matter of fact, we don't even know if there is a life beyond engineering or apart from engineering. Engineering, BPC, doctor, gaakunda, inkemana cheyochcha anedi manaku option kuda teliyadu. But akkadiki ellaka engineering kellaka akkada em chestunnamo kuda teliyadu. So don't follow something just because you had. Now already it's done. Engineering work ade chesam. Now let's stop it. Know what we are doing, and I hope everyone stop doing hard work and really enjoy their work. Because okay, if you did hard work and you got a very nice job, what will you do with that? You will get a nice salary. With that salary, you buy a new car, you buy a new house, you buy a nice double cot bed, everything is fine. And if you're doing something you like and you're earning only 20,000 per month, so the now if you compare this and this, now you have lots of luxuries with you, but weekly 5 days, the work time is 90% of your daily time. That 90% of your time, you are not liking it. And remaining 10% is what you enjoy these luxuries. And among that, once you sleep on the bed, after 2 minutes, you don't realize what bed it is, if it is a double cot bed or if you are sleeping on the floor. Padukunna gurtundadu. Manam eskunna battlu 1 minute tarvata manaku gurtundadu. We don't remember what we wore. We don't remember anything. Adi oka 5 seconds tarvata aanandam normal ayipothadi. Edaina sare. So it's just few seconds of happiness daily and remaining all sadness. Ikkada you are earning only 20,000 per month. But you are liking something you do. Ante 90% of the time you are enjoying. And remaining 10% of the time, it few seconds doesn't really matter because you are enjoying all the 90% of the time. So you call this as success or this? You call this big salary a success or this 20,000 a success? So now you decide.